Hello, walkers, and welcome to the Gallatin County Regional Park in Bozeman, Montana. It is, I think, 54 degrees Fahrenheit, 11 degrees Celsius. I think that's how that works out. And we are, it's about 2:30 p.m. on a Monday afternoon, and we're just going to take a little walk around and explore this relatively new park. We are in a newer section of town. In fact, within the last 15 years, for sure, probably within the last 10, these houses off to your right weren't here that 15 years ago. Certainly the houses off to the left and that fire station and church were not here. And this park wasn't here. I used to run my dog. It was Fields. And I would bring my dog out here and run him around, and have a jolly good time. That road wasn't there. It was sort of stopped down where that traffic light is. But that was then. This is now. I'm going to adjust the camera a little bit here. And we've got this great park now. We're going to start out here at this bicycle pump track, which is a pretty cool feature. There's somebody that's been riding on it. Now leaving. Hopefully I didn't scare him away. And it's a pretty slick little thing. So you can, kids or adults can go through here and take on the terrain. It says no walking on there, so I'm not going to do that. But it's a little bit like a skate park for bicycles, although not really, because I don't think you really do jumps and tricks and stuff. And there is another skate park over closer to downtown. Speaking of downtown, we are approximately, I would say, 2 to 3 miles from downtown, which is kind of that way-ish. We are about, I want to say, 4 or 5 blocks, maybe more, off of North 19th Street, which is a major commercial area. A lot of box stores and chain stores, that sort of thing. But it's I just wanted to walk around here. You can see sort of, I've talked a lot about the growth of Bozeman. And I wanted to show you a little bit of how that growth is manifesting itself. This is an older new section, I guess. They're starting to build out south of town now as well. We are walking towards the Bridger Mountains. Last year I did a hike up to the M, which is just kind of straight behind these little red looking trees. I can barely make out the M behind some other trees in the distance. And of course the Bridger Ridge, and then if you follow it far enough north, you will get to Bridger Bowl, which is north of Ross Peak area. In fact, I was thinking yesterday as I did a walk, and I was pondering other places I'd like to take you guys. Taking you up to Fairy Lake and Sacagawea Peak, which is up in the Bridgers. And it's a great hike, a great little area. It's a kind of a hike, drive to get up there. But it is a beautiful area. And hopefully this wind isn't too distracting for you. I put audio filters on here when I when the wind gets too bad, but it's not ideal. I do have a little wind muffler on my microphone, so that helps a little bit. My name is Henry. I am your proxy walker today, your virtual adventure guide, your perambulation something. I had another clever little term for that. Excuse me, pardon me. Anyway, I hope you enjoy these. Leave us your comments and subscribe and all that fun stuff, but mainly just enjoy the walk. This is a bouldering boulder, fake boulder, where people can come and practice their climbing skills, which is quite a fun thing for little kids to do, especially. At least that's where mine have enjoyed it over the years. We've got some pavilions for, which I presume you can reserve, but I don't know that for a fact. But you can come out here and have a picnic. And then they've got this lovely dinosaur park over there. My policy is to not film people's kids if I can help it, or at least not without their permission. So I'm going to avoid that. And it's, you know, a typical fun playground. It's a pretty nice one. But we're gonna head back to the main section of the park. Fun little footbridge here. So off to the left, you'll see, now I'm dropping, forgetting the name. I think that's Oak Street. Could have that way off. Going east-west, we're looking south now up towards Highlight. Did a couple walks there last summer. Check those out. Most of these are duplexes and townhouses. And then you'll start to get in another block or so in, you'll get detached homes and that sort of thing. As I said, these houses are not much older than 10 years, if that. And then on this side, you'll see some houses in the distance, and maybe I'll walk back in there. You can see they have a little bit more of a modern design in a lot of places. Most of those are going to be less than 10 years old. Probably less than, I want to say 5, but I think my sense of time as I get older is compressed. Off directly behind the playground with the cell tower there is one of the fire stations in town. It's got 3 bays. It's a really nice big fire station. And you can see a building that's actually being constructed as we speak up there. Over the years, they've done a lot of improvements to this park. It's really nice community benefit. I love cities that have parks and set aside some green space. There's a guy that was fishing earlier. I don't know if they stock this or not. I assume he knows. And then you'll see a hill in the distance. Now, when they built this, it was my understanding that they were going to turn that into kind of an amphitheater so people could bring out their blankets and sit on the hill, and then down below would be a stage. And for whatever reason, that I was either misinformed or that's just never happened. It is a great sledding hill though, and it's a lot of fun to take your bike up to the top and then whiz down. Especially if you're little, it's a lot of excitement, and it's a fun little perch to get up there. The lake itself, I saw a sign called Candida Lake. I thought that was like a bacterial infection or something, or a fungal infection, but I'm not familiar with my Latin medical terminology, so I could be wrong. It looks like there's a little duck out there, and it looks like a ruddy duck. Can't quite tell, but it's got the color and the shape. They're really pretty, and in the breeding season, the males have a pointy tail that sticks straight up vertically. And then here you've got a area where you can bring your dog and let him swim off leash. Of course you have to pick up after them, but I think that's pretty cool. When I was living over here, the only place to do that was over by the mall. Had a great little pond over there, but people weren't very good about cleaning up after their dogs. And, the E. coli count in there was apparently pretty bad, but still fun for the dog. And so you can see it over there. Hi there. And it's very well maintained. Looks like it's been raked recently. You can hear a robin going to town. A little later in the year, we'll get red-winged blackbirds over here, possibly yellow-winged blackbirds, more waterfowl, of course. And then out in this prairie area, you might get meadowlarks, which have a lovely sound, but man, are they powerful singers. We're gonna go over this fun little bridge and bench area, little footbridge. So if you do bring your dog, they have an off-leash area where I'm gonna take you in a little bit. I'll show you a quick map. so you can get an idea. And we're right in the middle of those two lakes. You can see the dog park just to the west. We'll head over there in a bit. But I love the design of this. I like the fact that they didn't just put the cheapest thing up that they could find. Oh, look at this little French bulldog. They made some design choices. Hi there.
Hi.
Look at this little guy. Oh, we're gonna go climb up the hill so we can get a good view. Dogs make me happy. I think I told you it was the time, the temp, and it's we're pushing mid-May here. I think it's the 10th. We'll go up to the top of this hill, get a nice little view of the surrounding area, and I can point out some of the ranges. My son would be able to point out every single one, as well as the major peaks. But I'm not as interested as he is in that sort of thing. In the comments below, if you would, let me know if you like these park walks and tell me where your favorite park is. I know that's sort of a cheap thing, but I love having this conversation. I did my first ever live stream, and I said this on my recent Old Chico Emigrant Gulch walk as well. I had so much fun talking to people, interacting with people on the chat, and I love hearing your stories. I love hearing your memories about these places. I love learning more about these places when I miss something or get something wrong. So give me a shout out in the comments. It's gonna get a little breezier up here. But you can see it's a really big park. And you can see that's due north, I think. You can see the Bridger Range, still plenty of snow up there. And you can see the, now if you go straight this direction, you'll hit like Costco and Target, REI. REI might be further south here. And then you can see the M on that mountain and the road up into Bridger Canyon. And I think that bus is on Davis, if you're interested in the mapping. And then kind of straight that way is the pass over to Bozeman, past Frog Rock. And then you get up into the Gallatins. And that's, I think, Sourdough Canyon in the distance. And then Highlight. And then you get down into the Gallatin Canyon and the Madisons, and then eventually you get back over to, I think those are the Bitterroots in the distance. But that gives you an idea of the size of this pike, the park. I'm gonna guess it's a quarter section, which makes it a quarter mile, which would be about a, 260 acres? That's a guess, don't hold me to that. Got somebody with their dog off leash over there, which I think is not an off leash area, but whatever. It's nice to have that open grassland though. One of the things I have been impressed with, I've talked a lot about the growth of Bozeman, the explosive growth of Bozeman. And one of the things I've been really impressed with, as I check my audio recorder, make sure it's still recording, it is, has been the density. It seems like there's a lot of sprawl, and there is, but you know, it's not all single family detached homes like it was when I first moved here. There's a lot of these straight ahead. You can see a row of townhouses, condominiums, multi-level, multi-family dwellings. And, you know, in a place where people come for the open spaces and the wild spaces, it's important to not pave those, right? To landscape them and to tear them up, because once they're gone, the fact is they just don't come back. You know, we almost never get those spaces back. So that's my perambulation pontification. Kudos to Bozeman, managing growth responsibly and wisely, in my opinion. And a little shout out to keeping open and wild spaces open and wild. And you know, it hasn't been easy for them. There's been a lot of back and forth and pushback, and but the community has done a great job of at least, you know, it could be better, but they've done a pretty good job given the situation. Again, in my opinion. I heard a red-winged blackbird there for a second. I also like the way they designed this dog park. It's a multi-gate system. For instance, this gal with a stroller and a dog, you know, it's not easy to get through a basic fence with managing all that. So she can open one gate, go through, close it, open the other gate without having to worry about letting dogs out. A nice little creek here. Clever little latch design. And look at this, they've even got a puppy area where you can have there, you can have your puppy run around without having to get rumbled or tumbled by the bigger dogs. It's a cute doodle. You can see that, mentioning the growth, there's several buildings under construction just within view of here. I had a comment from someone recently about moving out here, and I'd love to get a count of people. I've heard comments, several comments over the year about people moving out to Montana. And so if you're moving to Montana, I hope you'll give us a shout out in the comments. Let us know the general area of where you're moving to. Not your address, of course, but just kind of, you know, Bozeman area, Kalispell, Missoula, that kind of thing, Billings. I would love to get an idea. We're actually getting a second congressional district. There's a little ground squirrel over here. Just went down their little hole. Getting a second congressional district, and there's a lot of talk in the news and online about how that's going to work, how they're going to draw that. We have a very slanted government at the moment. It's not even close between Republicans and Democrats in terms of elected officials. That's how our elections went this year. This past year. So it'll be interesting to see. That's politics. I don't really care about that. But it is slightly interesting to hear about how things are going to balance out and how the mechanics will work. Hey there, pup.
Hi. Yeah. So, sweetie.
Dogs make me smile. I like these little pavilions too. Speaking of designs, I'm gonna walk you over here and we'll look at this little agility park. One of the things Bozeman's got a reputation for is the number of sheer number of dogs. People love their dogs. And having a lot of ranch dogs, a lot of heritage for ranch dogs, which tend to be really smart animals, there's a lot of interest in these agility trials. And you can see some stuff for people to work with their dog on, some tubes and ramps and hoops. Here's a little heeler of some sort. And then here's another beach. I think they have it fenced off so that the shore doesn't get super eroded and muddy. But they've even got I'll walk you around here. A pebble beach, which is nice. But they've also got a dock for the dogs to jump off of. And my guess is once a year at least, they used to, not here, but in another pond, they'd have a dog dock jumping competition to measure the distance. And you get your dog, you throw a ball or something for them, and they'll launch themselves off, presumably, into the water, and they measure the distance. I don't know if you guys have seen that on TV. It's fun. Here's a pretty one too. Black and white, brown. So this is Kona's Dock, in loving memory of Connie Johansson and her best friend for life, Miss Kona. That's fun. So I'm gonna walk us around the outskirts again, and then we'll go back into one of these neighborhoods just to see some of the new housing that's going up. I kind of like these modern designs that I'm seeing. Not so much this stuff, that's not that modern. I mean, it's nice, but these houses over here, I like that style, that sort of Nordic modern. I guess for lack of a better description, or for lack of knowledge, I guess. We'll get back into it in a minute, but if you do know the styles that I talk about without a whole lot of actual knowledge, put it in the comments. Love getting them. The other thing I wanted to mention is I've talked to the guy who is doing our Amazon and Roku channels. They've actually uploaded a lot more of the older videos, and a little basset hound there. So there's, I think, pretty much all the playlists, but none of the new stuff. I think the last ones were from October or November. But he's promising me that pretty soon they're gonna start updating them on a regular basis. So check those out, City Walks on Roku and Amazon Fire. And of course you can also, as most people have said, you can watch on YouTube on your TV. In fact, I was checking the analytics the other day and I was surprised at how many of you guys are watching these on the television. I think that's great. And it was fun for me today. I was talking with this guy, so I had to go back and I had to look through a couple of the videos and to watch some of those old walks from Switzerland and from London and Edinburgh. It was a lot of fun to remember those beautiful, beautiful places. Estonia, and where else did we go? Budapest. So that would have been Budapest would have been in January. So they must have updated some of them. That trip we went to Budapest, we went to Slovakia and had a couple from Austria as well, some Vienna specifically. Just before the lockdown started and while it was still safe to travel, presumably. Got a thundering herd about to come in here. I'll let them get some space. You can see these black and white, modern looking buildings. Hi there.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Come on, guys. Follow.
I'm gonna slide past you if that's all right.
He's in the corner.
Yeah.
He's a little slow.
Oh, that's all right. No rushing her. Have a good one. Olive's got her own agenda today. The other thing I like about these expanded areas is most of them have bike paths. There's not a lot of biking here in January, but the rest of the year, you know, it's a great way to get around town. There's no need to drive every single place if you have a decent bike. You can go to the grocery store, you can go to the bar, you can go to the movies, all that fun stuff. And I think Bozeman has done a decent job of ensuring that that infrastructure has been built in. It's something that over in Livingston we are pushing for and looking into. We don't have nearly the growth that Bozeman does, thank goodness. But it's coming, and we want to be prepared for it, and we want to have walkable and rideable community. So I'm actually not going to walk in here, but here's a little red-winged blackbird. See him? Fun. But you can get an idea of this sort of style of house, which is really nice. I like the mix of wood and simple metal and it's not industrial, but you know, modern. It's quite a playground back there too. It's pretty sweet. Although I have my doubts about that fence. In addition to the bike path, they have a bike lane, which is great. So if you, I forgot what street this, I just forgot to look at the street. I think it might be Ferguson. If you were to continue on down this road, if it is indeed Ferguson, and I am checking, Ferguson, you would get to Huffine Lane eventually. You get to Durston and then Huffine after crossing a bunch of things. Is this right? Anyway, you get down there, and eventually you get towards the mall. Not exactly the premier destination you might be looking for, but you would pass one of the new, brand new schools. I think it's 2 or 3 years old. It might be the new high school. There's now a second high school in Bozeman, and they're rehabbing the old high school. This looks pretty cool. And I'm gonna go back in here since we have this path. We'll walk around a little bit. It's a pretty sweet place to live, right near the park. And you have this sort of green space all through the development. I like it. Even smells like new house. You can see some condos going, or apartments going in the distance. Brand new foundation about to be poured over here. And on the other side is that green space I was talking about. And then between us and those new houses, those new builds going in, are some pavilions and a playground, as well as a path. Coming up on a cross street, and I'll be able to tell you what street this is called. Oh, I like this style. I think if I were going to live in Bozeman, this would be a good neighborhood for it, in my opinion. Let's always qualify that, of course. Different people have different tastes. This is Harvest Parkway going left, right, east, west. And I don't see, guess we'll see a sign here in a minute. Oh yeah, look, that's a great little green area. And we're on Ryun Sun, R-Y-U-N-S-U-N Way. I'm not sure what Ryun is. Crossover. There's our friend with Olive. We met going through the gate. Thank you. couple of happy dogs there. Happy times. It really is a beautiful place to live here. I mean, you're looking at those mountains, the other mountains to our south, all the time. When they're visible in the clouds. And they're really accessible, lots of trails, lots of public access. It's mostly national forest up there. I'll try and do some more walks in that area. Sipes Canyon would be a good one, I think. As the weather warms up, a lot of it still in, well, a lot of it still in snowy areas. Got a bald eagle flying over. Beautiful animal. Read recently their populations have skyrocketed since the 70s. Used to be really unusual to see them. And we made some changes to our regulatory environment, and there they are. It's more uncommon not to see them in Paradise Valley now. And the raven. Oh, I love these creeks, the way they smell. So nice. I guess it's really the willows that are so sweet smelling. Look at this little corgi coming. Jaunty fellow. You can see the bike paths. People climb up and then zoom down, the little kids mainly. And I remember doing that, something like that as a kid. So much fun, so exciting. We're gonna climb back up here real quick. We're gonna climb back up here because that's gonna be where we're gonna finish up. I wanna thank you guys all for coming around, watching these videos, sharing with your friends, subscribing, commenting, liking, all that fun stuff. I really do value the interactions. I love hearing how these videos are helpful or enjoyable. And I love it when you guys share your thoughts and that sort of thing. And I hope you'll continue to do so. I want to thanks again. We will see you again soon somewhere in Montana. Not sure where yet exactly, but from the Gallatin County Regional Park. Thanks so much, see you again soon. Till then, keep on steppin'.